Hello everyone, and welcome to another Star Wars Old Republic video, and this video is going to be a small and short guide video regarding the new currency we have in patch 5.2, the War for Iokath. Now as you know, Iokath dailies both give and require Iokath shards. Now these shards can be used for piloting walkers, turrets, and mouse droids. Some of these are required for you to actually complete the dailies, while others can be used to give you the upper hand during open world PvP on Iokath, which actually unfortunately rarely happens, but mostly they're just used for unleashing mayhem and killing tons of enemies. Now unfortunately these items are pretty expensive, and so you are going to want to know, you know, all the ways you can acquire this new currency, which is what this video is all about. So let's get started. Firstly, the obvious yet most tedious and inefficient way of getting these shards is simply killing enemies on Iokath. Now usually enemies drop around 1 to 2 shards each, but not every enemy will drop them. After playing through the entire expansion, I got around 100 shards from killing enemies, so it's not a very efficient way of getting them, but nonetheless, everything you do on Iokath requires you to kill enemies, so it's a pretty steady source of income. Secondly, enemies do have a chance of dropping these Iokath shard crates. Now you can also get these crates from completing the dailies on the planets. They come in two rarities. The blue one gives around 5 to 10 shards, and the purple one gives anywhere from 20 to 30 shards. So not the best, but still very decent. And what you should note about these crates is that they can be sold on the GTN. Not sure if this is a glitch or if this is intended by BioWare, but at this point in time, they can be sold, and BioWare's done nothing to patch it. So this means two things. Firstly, if you don't really care about farming shards, you can make quite a few credits selling these crates on the GTN. Both crates sell in the range of 150 to 300,000 credits at the moment on the Harbinger server. On the flip side, if you care more about these shards than credits, you can buy these shards from the GTN by getting these crates. Now they're pretty expensive, so if you want to get into the thousands, you're probably going to have to pay a few million credits, but hey, if you care more about these shards, then it's a pretty good way of spending your credits. Another way to get shards is actually exchanging crafting materials for them. So if you don't want to spend your credits, you don't got the time to farm, you can actually exchange crafting materials, which once again you can just buy off the GTN, or you could use your various gathering skills you have acquired and get these crafting materials. Now there is a vendor next to the GTN in both the Imperial and Republic camps. You can interact with this vendor by starting up a conversation, and the vendor gives you the option of trading in a variety of green crafting materials for shards. So they're green, you don't need to get the blue or the purple ones. Keep in mind, you are going to have to trade in though like 12 to 15 materials for just one shard, so it is pretty expensive in that regard. I did do a quick check to see if these crafting materials are available from the Jawa vendors, because that could be an excellent way of converting your Jawa scrap that you might have saved up, but unfortunately the Jawa vendors do not provide these materials. You can, however, as I talked about earlier, consult the GTN and see if anyone is selling these mats at a really decent price, because oftentimes these mats don't go for very much. Just the other day I did pick up 250 of the blue crystals for 200 credits each, which is an awesome deal considering how many shards I got for it. So basically it's another way of spending credits to try to get shards, or once again you can just farm these crafting materials. You could go to the planets where these crafting materials are and you can like use your gathering skills to get them, or you can just use your, you know, send your companions out on the missions and stuff. Now the final way to get shards, but also probably the least practical at this point, is to kill other players on Iokath by entering a PvP instance. The reason this is impractical is because literally no one plays on PvP instances right now. The few times I've been there are only like 2 to 3 people on that instance, and I would love to rant right now about how much of a failure open world PvP on Iokath was, but I'll leave that for another video. Anyways, that is the end. So these are all the ways right now to get shards at the moment. Hopefully BioWare will look into kind of reducing the cost for some of these items. It's pretty ridiculous to, you know, think that they're gating some of this Iokath content behind a currency, and especially considering how time consuming it is to farm this currency. So in any case, you know, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys are having a good time farming these things. There's a lot of really cool stuff you can do with it. You can actually play as Tithe, you know, the God of Rage that you have to fight in the Operation boss. If you have 2300 shards and the Tithe command module, you can actually play as the boss himself, which is super cool. I'm actually doing a separate video tutorial on how to do that, because that's just about the coolest thing I've ever seen in this game right now. But anyways, hope you guys enjoyed. I hope you guys found it informative, and I'll see you in the next one.